लास्ट 5 सेकेंड्स, रेडी स्टार्ट। एज पर सेक्शन 2H ऑफ द 1997 एक्ट रेड विद सेक्शन 230 ऑफ द एक्ट 1988, इवन ए पर्सन इन पोजेशन ऑफ द व्हीकल अंडर द हायर परचेज एग्रीमेंट और एन एग्रीमेंट ऑफ सेल और एन एग्रीमेंट ऑफ हाइपोथिकेशन कैन ऑल्सो बी सेड टू बी द ओनर. Therefore, a financier like the appellant who is in possession of the transport vehicle in question owing to non-payment of the loan is an owner under the relevant provisions of the 1997 Act and the 1988 Act. Section 4 of the 1997 Act is the charging section. As per Section 4, no motor vehicle other than a transport vehicle shall be used in any public place in Uttar Pradesh unless a one-time tax at the rate applicable in respect of such motor vehicle has been paid in respect thereof. Section 4.2a provides that no public service vehicle, transport vehicle other than those referred in subsection 1A and subsection 2 shall be used in any public place in Uttar Pradesh unless a monthly tax at such rate as may be notified by the state government is paid in respect thereof. It further provides that in respect of a motor vehicle under section 4.2a, instead of monthly tax, a quarterly or a yearly tax at such rate as may be notified by the state government may be payable. Section 9 provides for payment of tax and penalty. As per section 9.1.4a, the tax payable under subsection 2A of section 4 shall be payable in advance for one calendar month at the time of registration of the vehicle under the Motor Vehicles Act 1988 and thereafter on or before the 15th day of each calendar month next following. Section 12 provides for non-use of vehicle and refund of tax as per section 12.1. When any person who has paid the tax in respect of a transport vehicle proves to the satisfaction of the taxation officer in the prescribed manner that the motor vehicle in respect whereof such tax has been paid has not been used for a continuous period of 1 month or more since the tax was last paid, he shall be entitled to a refund of an amount equal to 1/3 of the rate of quarterly tax or 1/12 of the yearly tax as the case may be payable in respect of such vehicle for each 30 days of such period for which such tax has been paid. However, section 12.2 provides that where the operator or as the case may be the owner of a motor vehicle does not intend to use his vehicle for the period of 1 month or more, he shall before the date the tax or additional tax as the case may be is due surrender the certificate of registration, the token if any issued in respect of the motor vehicle and the permit if any to the taxation officer of the region where the tax or additional tax was last paid and on such surrender no tax or additional tax under the 1997 Act shall be payable in respect of such vehicle or for each complete calendar month of the period during which the vehicle remains withdrawn from use and the aforesaid documents remain surrendered with the taxation officer as per proviso to subsection 2 of section 12 in case such vehicle is found plying during the period when its documents as mentioned in subsection 2 of section 12 remain surrendered with the taxation officer, such owner or operator as the case may be shall be liable to tax and additional tax as if the documents were not surrendered, and shall also be liable to penalty equivalent to 5 times of the tax and additional tax. On a conjoint reading of the aforesaid provisions, it can be seen that in respect of a transport vehicle, the tax is to be paid in advance as monthly tax or yearly tax as the case may be, and only thereafter such vehicle shall be put to use. Therefore, before any transport vehicle is put to use or used, the owner is liable to pay the tax in advance, and only thereafter the vehicle can be used or operated. The wordings of section 4.2a are very clear that no public service vehicle shall be used in any public place unless a monthly tax at such rate as may be notified by the state government is paid in respect thereof as per section 9.1.4a. The tax payable under subsection 2a of section 4 shall be payable in advance on or before 15th day of each month next following. Therefore, the requirement under law is to first pay the tax in advance as provided under section 9 and thereafter to use the vehicle. In other words, it is pay the tax and use, and not use and pay the tax. Stop.